So it's time to say, welcome back. Today we're going to be playing a political game simulator in which we simulate an alternate reality which in no way has any correspondence to modern events. So with that, let's get started. And by correspondence, I mean correlation. You get it. You get the idea. That looks cool. Ooh, that could get annoying quickly. Let's turn that just ever so slightly down. Alright, let me know if there's any issues with it. I assume that it's at 720p. I assume that everything balances out noise-wise. So, let's go back. This actually has a multiplayer version. If anybody else had this, we could do multiplayer. But no, let's get started. A new terrorist threat. A still contentious healthcare reform package. And new domestic issues have tempers flaring across the political spectrum. Get ready to lie, cry, pander, and slander your way to victory. The 21-week season? Yeah. Sure, this seems like a great way to start. Simulate campaign. Don't even play the game. Wow. That's a cool feature. Alright, create. Here we go. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Alright, let's make this just to be ridiculous. Oh my goodness. These are not the candidates that you're looking for. They're so not the candidates you're looking for. Former First Lady's long political career has included spells serving both as a senator and secretary of state, giving her both experience and baggage. Her presidential campaign is focused on healthcare and women's rights. Wait, who's this guy? Interesting. Did not know that. Alright, so let's pick somebody. Just completely at random. He has yellow hair, and a double chin, and some other qualifications. Okay, let's go. Sure, why not? Why not? What's the worst that could happen? We could lose. Make states turn red. Select your candidate, and right-click on a state to move there, and then take action in that state. Raise your awareness in each state. If you have no awareness, people won't vote for you. Match your stance on issues to win like-minded voters. Okay. So, we're out in New York with a measly $3.5 million in pocket, income of $10,000. You could check all kinds of polls, or you could just go around. Building buildings to support your campaign. So if I were Trump, where would I go? Where is going to be a routine stop on my campaign? Let's see. Somewhere that I can go over and over and know they'll want me. I mean, I could start in Florida. They don't have tons of money, though. I'm thinking Texas. Now, isn't there a way I can filter the map to show me money? Electoral votes, state wealth. There we go. So all the wealth's in California, Texas, Florida, Illinois, and New York. Only some of which are blue states. Let's take a ride on down to Texas. So let's click our candidate. You can see his little head bobbles each time we click him. Wait, we've already got a building over here, right? I mean, surely we've built something. Let's see, what is this? This is my Luxion HQ. Yep, I've got a building in New York. And it's not a hotel. Alright. Let's click the little dude. Let's move on down to Texas. And we've got 9 stamina remaining. Let's build a thing. Right? Need bonuses to win. Somehow I feel that an outreach center is not something I'm going to be building. Just saying. It'd be cool to have some consultants. They could definitely help. But no, let's build another HQ right here. And we've got 6 stamina remaining, and let's see. You can give speeches to raise money. What's this about fundraising, I wonder? Okay. I don't know the difference. Oh, wait. A speech would be to try to raise awareness of me, and then we could do a fundraiser after the speech. Or during it. Ideally. Let's see. What's a matter that Texans really care about? So, independents and Republicans in Texas apparently like gun rights. I'm kind of surprised that there's a split here, but okay. Election integrity. Oh yeah, I support election integrity. Everybody knows. I do the best election integrity. Oh, but no, one thing, you can actually, like, get us a sense of how important these issues are, not just the way, but you need some sort of political strategist to tell you which issues are more important than other issues. Let's see. Where's the map that shows you, like, strategy planning. This is how I want things to turn out in the end, apparently. Where I do get the vote. There's polls. So yeah. Just in general, people... I think this is in general. I don't know if this is specific to Texas, but these are things... Oh. Yeah, so securing the borders is apparently something that voters care strongly about. Apparently, election integrity is not something voters value too highly. So yeah, let's give our talking point that, you know, we really want to give this point. Just kind of wing it. Let's see. Yeah. Let's build a wall. I like having the biggest wall. Oh, is he already exhausted? Yeah, that took 5 stamina for him to give a speech. Looks like week 1 of 21 is done. So with that, I'll give another speech. Say, guys, you know, last time I said we should build a wall. This time, I'm saying we should build a wall. Aren't walls great? Alright, so... And then, see... Do people want to give me money? Sure. Okay. Yeah. I could see guns being an important issue, too. Maybe I should go to Florida and tell them about this great wall. Okay, I've got 3 stamina remaining, which is just enough to do another fundraiser. Yeah, now I'm getting the sense of how to play this. Just go around saying whatever you want to say, and taking people's money. Okay, apparently I've got not such a lead here. I'm sorry, in Florida I've got not a lead. In Texas I've totally got it locked down, but... Oh, I can't move because I've used up all my stamina. Duh. Okay. So, we're gonna go to Florida and give a speech. Oh, okay. What else? Securing the borders, Social Security. Yeah, I support election integrity. That's something you all will care about by the time I'm done. Maybe. Maybe not. Alright, let's build a consulting office. I have exhausted my energy for that turn. So, let's go to week 4 of 21. Well, I'm not saying I'm gonna win. I'm just saying that's the way to play the game. Here. We get it. Don't need to have that help thing every time. Yeah, this is something that's important in Florida. So, let's speak about it. Let's see. Can we afford any operatives? Oh, we get one political capital a week because we have one political capital office. Or one, whatever it is, community outreach. That's not a community outreach center. That's some kind of political operative strategist office that gets him one political capital a week. All right. Let's get some money. Let's double dip. Cool. Alright, where do we want to go next, guys? Yeah. Well, that's the thing. We can hire an operative. Nice. Oh, we actually get that as a function of having speeches. That's pretty cool. Let's see. Well, we do have 6 political capital, because we've given some speeches and have a... Let's see, what would be something important given my character's qualifications? Credibility might be something I want somebody for. My credibility seems too high. Also, my media bias is not that great. So what can we do about my credibility and media bias? I mean, credibility... Who needs that? But we need somebody for the media. Okay. Let's see. PR consultant. Fashion consultant. Nice. Having a media guy is kind of cool. Man, wow, that's special. The media is a vicious institution that jumps on unfavorable candidates' mistakes, like a lion on a piece of raw meat. PR consultant lives and breathes damage control and ensures every interaction with the media benefits the campaign. Yeah, that's something that we need for sure. Just saying. Yeah, you're probably right. Alright, let's go... Pennsylvania? Indiana? That's Kentucky. Okay. Yeah, let's go to Virginia. And give a speech about, you know, who doesn't like the Confederate flag? Just kidding. Oh, actually, I think these are probably ranked in order of what's important to the people of the state. If I remember right from the previous game. Yeah. Let's give another speech. I support religious freedom. Because that's totally what I do. Heated race takes early toll on Trump. Ooh, that's no good. So optimism was ignored at the Clinton camp, where staff members are thrilled with the early results. Okay, cool. Election update. Oh, that's the thing we just read. We got, so this is what happened this week. So we got a PR consultant. We gave some speeches about how flags are cool. We gave some speeches about how I support religious freedom. Candidate drew a reasonable sized crowd and did a good job getting both his message and, more importantly, his name into the minds of the voters. We're proud of Donald's work on the campaign trail, one speechwriter noted. We just write the stuff, he's the one who makes it work. Hillary's won the endorsement of the Environmentalists Club. They're an organization dedicated to protecting the environment. They support laws that limit pollution and protect the environment, such as protecting the environment and making sure that the environment is protected. Okay. Well, good to see that that was lovely and vague and stuff. Oh, I probably want to build something before I move. Let's build a thing. Endorsements would ultimately be a good thing to have. As much as I want to deny the fact that I'm going to have an outreach center, let's build one. Alright. And then, yeah. Move on to Pennsylvania. My arrival itself has boosted, I don't know, my vote. I don't know if this is vote. Actually, this is the awareness thing I was looking for. The meters for this game look a little bit different. So. Let's secure the borders. Because, you know, that's super important to the people of Pennsylvania, is that we have a secure border. Oh, hey, look, there's a little question mark thing here. Yes, let's go up to, I think that's Vermont. A sneaky know-it-all, known as a scandalmonger, has joined forces with Donald Trump to dig up dirt. Their opponent will have their integrity halved in whatever state the scandalmonger's in. Okay, so what's an important state? I don't know if I can take New York, but man. Let's see if we can take it. Alright. That'd be kind of cool to claim our own home state there. Let's see, we got tons of money. You know, I should probably give a speech while I'm out here, just to let people know who I am. Oh, in fact, that's not Vermont. This is Vermont. While I'm here, let's give a speech. Something about Second Amendment rights. Be that a bit of a contradiction there, but yeah, whatever. Who's counting? But yeah, let's go on to New York. And give a speech about... Ooh, what can we talk about? I don't know if that sounds like us. Let's talk about... No. There's really no way to spin that, is there? Opponent opposes secure borders. I can't get everybody to agree on everything. Sure. Whatever. Let's do it. Nothing like a vague commitment in advance of an election. Next turn. Well, let's build a thing. Oh yeah, upgrade a thing. Sure, why not? Hillary Clinton's won the endorsement of the National Association for Women. National Association for Women is an organization dedicated to promoting the rights of women. They are particularly interested in ensuring continued access to abortion and the promotion of equal treatment of the sexes. Yeah, you're actually right. We do need some endorsements to be able to get somewhere. So, let's see. We don't have enough points to get an endorsement just yet. But let's make a pit stop somewhere. So, unless we want to do this whole campaign by ourselves, but that seems a bit crazy. So let's build a thing. As the game's suggesting, let's build an outreach center. Really not my character style, but what can you do? Alright. End the turn there. And let's build a thing. Build another campaign HQ. Let's see. Can we afford another operative? Oh yeah, we could totally afford some operatives. Let's get a speechwriter. Every syllable spoken by presidential candidates analyzed and broken down and stepped on by political pundits. Speechwriter ensures that Donald Trump is getting the proper message across to voters everywhere, with just the right amount of heartwarming personal narrative. I mean, that doesn't quite sound like our candidate, but what can you do? Yeah, let's pick a fashion consultant. Fashion consultant focuses on what's important, the canvas of the body. Every day is a chance for Donald Trump to wear something stunning, to woo over the shallow demographic that cares about such matters. Oh yeah, going for those shallow voters. Have I built a thing? I'm pretty sure I just did. Let's see. Yeah, okay. Let's talk about important matters, such as what's going on halfway around the globe, because that's what people of Indiana care about. Let's see. Yeah, that could be kind of tricky to take. I'm not sure if I could get Washington State. So what's our strategy map looking like? Yeah, we're totally winning this strategy map thing. Let's try to take Michigan. Alright, let's pick a running mate, guys. Who should we pick? Let's throw a dart at a dartboard. And by that, I mean, let's pick this guy. He looks cool. Nobody knows anything about him. Let's pick him. Alright, where is he going? Do I just want to leave him there? Or do I want to send him on a mission somewhere? Yeah, he could be helpful over here. Yeah, have fun there. Okay. Have I built a thing here yet? Nope. Let's build another outreach center. And do some fundraising. Except not. Let's give a speech. Man. I favor election integrity. But not as much as I favor this. Okay, and yeah, let's go on. Let's head on back to Florida. It's important to let people remember who I am. Let's go. Trump maintains a steady second place showing halfway through campaign. Continuing is showing a mediocrity in the second half of the election period. Polls still show I'm trailing behind frontrunner. We're going to break out of this rut, one of my staff members insisted. We got the first half of the race establishing ourselves. Now it's our time to shine. The verge of irrelevancy, Volunteers working for a Clinton campaign expressed an upbeat optimism for their candidate. Do we have to really wait another 10 weeks to win? I mean, this is going to be embarrassing. They should really consider throwing in the towel. All right. And yeah. I like the way that this displays, although it doesn't show you anything that you don't already know. Clinton's won the endorsement of the National Civil Liberties Union. The National Civil Liberties Union is an organization dedicated to protecting the First Amendment to the U.S. Constitution. All right, let's get an endorsement. Ooh, purple states are battleground states. Yeah, we've turned New York, which is usually a blue state, it's now a battleground state, guys. All right. Is this the endorsement we want? Is this the endorsement we want? We've got 9 PR clouds, so we have to pick something that has a 7 or an 8 or a 9. U.S. Chamber of Business. You know, that actually sounds like something I could win the endorsement for. Doesn't help me pick up any votes, but, you know, it's a thing I could win. Yeah, there is no NRA. There's just the National Gun Owners Association. But, you know, that actually makes sense in light of events. Maybe that's the endorsement we're aiming for. Let's do it. The National Gun Owners Association is an organization dedicated to promoting gun rights. Never mind the side effects that go with that. Alright. Let's see. Yeah, sure. If we... Let's do a fundraiser, because you can never have enough money. Let's do one more. Oh yeah, just turning in all the money. Oh, we've got, what do we want to do here? Let's see. How about this guy? This guy looks like a welcome guy on my campaign. You'll knock down campaign signs, put pressure on stations, and lower awareness and keep people away from the polls in a variety of underhanded techniques. Also use overhanded techniques when necessary. Wow, that's pretty extreme. This seems like a better way to go. Yeah. This seems like a much more civil way to go. Alright, where did my guy go? Where did that dude show up? Is he down here somewhere? No. Where did he go? Oh, I missed out on this. Hopefully the later show will still be there next time. I'm not sure where my operative went. He's there somewhere. I'm sure we'll run into him eventually. Yeah, that's a shame I missed out on the later show, because it was way in the corner of the map and I didn't see it. Well, that's done. There is a question mark in Ohio, although Clinton seems to have nabbed it. So I can't nab it. Bummer. Maybe next time we'll get to do one of those show things. Should we go to Missouri? Whoops. Oh, here we go. I accidentally figured this out. Operatives. So you can choose to hide your headquarters and just... Yeah, here's my scandal manager. Smear merchants hanging out... Oh, in Florida. Okay, cool. Yeah, let's go on to Missouri. Let people know who I am. Let's see. To build another consulting office, another outreach center. What do we build? Yeah, let's build one of these. Okay. And give a speech on how something we all agree on. Sure. Donald Trump opposes supporting gay marriage. You never know. So what people want to hear, you have to tell the people what they want to hear, apparently. Let's see, do we go... Where... 10 votes at stake, 10 votes at stake, 6, 10, 6. Let's go to another 10 somewhere. Yeah, sure. Oh. Yeah, I've got the energy to fly there. There we go. And I've completely forgotten about... Oh, then no, that thing was taken by my opponent. Whatever it was. So, let's build another HQ. Sure, why not? Hillary Clinton has won the endorsement of the National Organization for the Support of Colored People. The National Organization for the Support of Colored People is an organization that fights for the rights of African Americans and other racial minorities. Okay. Yeah, let's secure the border. Okay, let's pick... I don't know. What do we do? Decreases your advertising revenue... or costs. Lowers opponent awareness. Alright, where is that guy? Where did my asset go? Oh, I can hit the assets button to figure this out. Include operatives. Don't include headquarters. Oh, this guy's in Wisconsin. Can I move him? There he is. Where do I want this guy? Yeah, let's go to Texas. He seems kind of at home there. Let's make a quick stop at Texas. And make a quick stop over Florida. Awesome. That was easy. Ooh, we can win an endorsement. Okay, we got it. Let's take an endorsement, guys. Got 14 PR. Should we get the National Foreign Policy Committee on our side? They're dedicated to promoting a foreign policy that will protect American interests across the globe and keep Americans safe at home. Or do we want to appeal to these guys? Yeah, let's do this one. This is an important endorsement, guys. It's a grassroots organization dedicated to reducing taxes, cutting spending, and shrinking the size of the federal government, which is totally something my candidate supports, and not an endorsement I'm just seeking for the fact that helps me become popular. It'd be nice if we could do a debate or something. I did miss out on that one TV show opportunity. Hopefully others will be there. So let's go pursuing some votes in Pennsylvania. We haven't built anything here. Or we have. Let's upgrade it. Nice. Didn't mean to double click that, but cool. We've got 6 stamina remaining. Let's secure the border. Wait, yeah, okay, I found the button to give the speech. It's an important button. And let's go back to our home state. Ooh, Ohio's turned blue. I should perhaps do something about that. Alright. Well, do I have any chance of taking this? Also, how's that affecting our vote? We're predicting that's going to turn red. Or projecting, rather. So maybe we do have to make some ads. Let's make a stop in Ohio. And see what is it that the folks of Ohio want me to talk about. Let's talk about issues halfway around the world. Election integrity. Alright. I favor election integrity. Weekly expense of $30,000. Yeah, we can afford it. I did create that, right? So if I look for ads, I should see it. Yeah. Nice. Where's my dude? Yeah, this guy. We actually need his help up here. So, that'll be a good thing. Let's give a speech about how election integrity is so super important. And we got 2 stamina remaining. So, gotta go visit Florida again. Hi, Florida. And bye, Florida. You can give a speech here in New York. Oh, actually, we don't need money. We're doing well on money. Let's pick up some endorsements, such as from the U.S. Chamber of Business. Okay, so let's get an operative. Let's see. Consultant. That might not be a bad thing to have. Also, this seems like something that my campaign would have much more of, although I already have one of those. Yeah, let's hire a consultant. Where's my consultant? Surely he showed up. Oh, they're like behind my head. If I can click on them, that'd be great. I cannot click on my consultant because my large head is in. Oh, I'm sorry, that's part of my head. That apparently is part of my head. Oh no, I got it. Political operative. Increases awareness. There's my consultant, though. We're gonna move them into Ohio. Alright, so have I given a speech here yet? I think we need to do that. Let's talk about... Sure, why not? Okay, I guess they're tired of that topic. Who knew? Apparently the game knew. Sure, let's take Michigan. And Ohio. I'm sorry, that's not Ohio. I meant Iowa. You know what I meant. Let's build an HQ. And talk to people about farm subsidies. You know, because that's a really interesting topic. Let's see, where else do I go? Let's briefly hit Nebraska. Hi, Nebraska. Bye, Nebraska. Let's take an endorsement from, National Foreign Policy Committee. Seems like something I would not normally take. Could be cool. Yeah, actually, this one kind of fits with our stance, so let's take that. Hey, look, there's a little question mark here. My opponents ignored it for once. Let's build a campaign HQ. Oh, you know I should have done much earlier this game. It's just gone around everywhere building headquarters and such. Let's make a stop in Minnesota and make a stop in Oregon. And how's it hanging in Oregon? Oh, that's no good. All right, well, how unfortunate that we have a lawsuit which drains 560,000 from our reserves, which have 560,000 in them. Well, it looks like we're kind of stuck, aren't we? All right, that's kind of an issue, isn't it? All right, guys, we're gonna give a speech about how great drugs are. Sure. Because that's totally what my candidate believes in. Guys, help me get on a plane out of here. Let's visit some states, see some sights, and end up in Nevada. All right, we're on week 20 of 21. we're gonna talk about how great it is to have employment, just in general. Okay, we're actually ahead there. Ahead here. We're still behind here. Down here. Actually, let's move our guys. Let's move these guys up here. Let's see. Oh, nice. You can actually see things at this level, too. People are pretty aware that I'm down there. Okay. I can actually get a really detailed breakdown of what's going on in New York. Yeah, right. It would have been better to go to a different state and do a fundraiser. So you can tell that the people in New York are not single-minded. They care about a lot of issues. And they care more strongly about some issues than about others. So, if I could go to New York and talk to them about how great it would be to reduce the wealth gap, or how great it would be to support things that are going on halfway around the world, that might be a good thing for my campaign. Let's go there and talk about the wealth gap. That seems like a critical issue for me to speak about. Nobody supports the wealth gap more than my candidate. I mean, reducing the wealth gap. Okay. I don't know if they believe me. Oh, hey, look. They kind of sort of believe me. Maybe I have to give the speech a second time for them to actually believe it. Okay. Sure. Let's win an endorsement. Sure. Spin Doctor, help me out. Also, 29 votes are at stake in New York and 29 in Florida. Is there any chance that I could take Florida? Yeah, it looks like I could take it. Alright, so, comes down to the wire. Here we go. Another high-energy speech on drone warfare from Clinton. Alright. No, it looks like I've got Florida kind of locked down. At least 50% of the vote. Everybody knows who I am. But maybe I want to still send somebody out to take care of those last few votes. Yeah, let's send this dude out here. Not sure if that's necessary or not. Let's get another one of those. Oh, I don't have enough. Never mind. Let's get, let's see. If there's an operative that I want to eliminate, that'd be a good thing. I guess pretty innocent. Is there anybody that I could really target? Let's see. So wait, why is the state blue? Oh, it's blue because I didn't go there. My bad. If I go there and actually give a speech, people might know who I am. See, let me actually go there. That's about 20 votes that I can contest. In a legal manner, I can contest these things. So let's get our fixer out here. There we go. It's been fixed. Let's talk about how great drugs are. And talk about... I don't know. Sure. Talk about fighting ISIL. And here we go. Election night is upon us. Let's just roll the dice. And let the chips fall where they may. Ooh, we lost New York. That's too bad. Alright, so. We're trailing by 36, trailing by 8, leading by 11, leading by 27, then by 56. It's a pity to lose New York like that. I think I should have built more headquarters early on. Really, I should have. But it seems like I'm doing okay. We did play this in easy mode, so the outcome's not much of a surprise. Alright, I think we got it, guys. I think we got it. Huh. Alaska went for us. Who knew? That's too bad that we didn't win them all. Trump has won the day in the presidency with a strong showing in both the vote and the Electoral College. One of the deciding factors was the use of political capital, which he actually used. Trump spent more money. Money may not buy you love, but apparently it can buy you votes. So yeah, we can take a look at the exit polls, find out that securing the borders and fighting halfway around the world and something about emails were pretty important issues. So that said, let's try this again from a bit of a different perspective. Alright, let's create a game. Let's play as Oops. Hang on. Select candidate. Yeah, we're playing at this candidate now. And let's pick this guy, Baldy, as our opponent. Alright. So, let's upgrade our headquarters right off the bat. Let's go where all the money is. Build a thing. Okay. And we got one stamina left. So let's set up for next turn. Let's head over here. And we're done. Let's build another building. Let's go to Illinois. Build a building. And go, I don't know, California. Oh no, you don't. You're not taking my California away from me. I say, as I just keep building buildings. And not giving any speeches whatsoever. But you know, eventually we'll get some endorsements somehow. Let's see, should we build... Let's go to Missouri. That's 10, 8, 8, 6, 10, 10, 12, Washington. Apparently that's important. They've got money. Let's go to Washington. Build a thing. Okay. And then let's go... Oops. There's 8 votes there. 7. I've got 5 stamina left. Yeah, what the heck. Let's go to Alabama and see what happens when we go there. Nice. A visit was worth it. Okay. Let's see, let's go to Pennsylvania. Build a thing. Go to Michigan. Build a thing. Let's get some operatives. Let's see, what would actually be something useful for my candidate? Can I see attributes of my candidate? Info. Here we are. Credibility, religious, stamina, money. Huh. It's a pretty well-rounded candidate, so... Interviews become more effective. Yeah, let's pick up this guy. You never know when we're going to end up in an interview situation. Okay, let's build a thing. Can I afford it? I think so. It costs $500,000 to upgrade. Sure, why not? So let's go, I don't know. I think I've built as many things as I can build. And now I have to start going places and trying to collect money. Seems like a fair place to go. Let's give a speech or two and then collect some cash. Let's see. Yeah, let's do something about climate change, I guess. I don't know. Yeah, climate's important. You gotta be able to control the weather, guys. You know, that's an interesting policy. You might be able to win the game that way. That could be an interesting challenge, for sure. He's won the endorsement of the Christian Confederation. They're promoting and dedicating, traditional values. So let's give one more speech. Something about opponent, or yeah, I oppose having secure borders. Oh no, people don't like that. That's too bad. All right, let's get some money. And let's go on, yeah, let's go here. Where some kind of surprise awaits us. Nice. We get the money. Raises your fundraising potential by 25% in the target state. Where'd he go? Oh, I could put him in any state. Well, clearly, you know, we're gonna put him in California. Alright, let's go straight on down to Florida. Sure. Suppose we don't need a PR or a fashion consultant just yet. Let's get a speech writer, because, you know, it's difficult to come up with good speeches. See, this is something I should have noticed last time I was playing, is that big gong noise, letting you know that, hey, by the way. Alright, so... sure. Let's win the endorsement. We've read this last time. They promote equal treatment of the genders or sexes. Can we afford to build anything? Yep. Let's do it. Let's give a speech. Zika funding's super important. And then we'll go on up to North Dakota. And play a minigame. Would we like to appear on Good Day? It's a morning show with some slightly over-caffeinated hosts where the questions will be more about character issues. It generally the show you want to be on. You'll get to get your message out to a broad audience while avoiding difficult questions that may alienate voters. Today on Good Day, we investigate the troubling topic of video game violence, Nancy Frags some punk sucksores, and we have a brief sit-down with a politician of some sort. What are you going to do about gas prices? Are they going to be low or high or low or high? I buy everyone gas. Yeah. Would you legalize marijuana? Oh man, I don't know. Other drugs are better than marijuana, you know. Awesome. Well, that was fun. We're definitely pandering. Oh dear. Dude, did I not hire a media guy? Apparently I didn't. I got a speech writer, but that's for speeches. Apparently I might need... I've got a PR consultant. So... hard to say how that went wrong. Okay, well, apparently, you know, that PR consultant just wasn't there doing their job. Okay. Here, let's pick this guy. This guy seems like a good running mate. Let's see, where'd my running mate go? Seems like an important question to answer. Who's that? Oh, there it is. Wow. From a distance, it's kind of hard to tell who they are. Let's see, where do I want you? You can help me win... I don't know. Let's go Ohio. Okay, let's build an outreach center. It's just gonna build all the buildings. Let's see, can I go to Illinois and build a thing? Nice. Okay. Sure. Not sure why ads would be so important if I'm not, like, making ads. Let's get one of those. Alright. Enter. Oh, let's win some more endorsements. Such as from the Environmentalist Club. And yeah, let's get another operative. Yeah, okay, fine. We'll get a fashion consultant. Not sure that that's actually going to help us, but it wouldn't hurt. Okay, let's go on to Ohio. We haven't built anything here yet. Let's upgrade that. Give a speech. Let's do something about the wealth gap. Alright, whatever. We missed out on our opportunity in South Carolina. It's too bad. On the other hand, who knows what that could have been. Yeah, let's get one of those. Let's see, where did this person show up? I can't see them because there's so many people in Ohio. Let's go back up here to Washington State. Let's get this guy on down to Texas. He's gonna feel just at home there. Let's upgrade our consulting office and give a speech where we talk about how drugs are cool. Apparently everybody agrees. Turn 13. Well, it looks like we got Ohio. So, Mr. Clinton, you can go... Hmm. 13, 15 votes. Yeah, let's go on down here. Try to win that state. Meanwhile, I'm gonna go back to California. And, see, people know who I am yet? Let's give one more speech to raise awareness of just who I am in the state. Yeah, let's talk about climate change. Get some money. Nice. So many options. Raise your awareness by 4% per week. Huh. Well, those cost 9 now. On the other hand, this does not cost 9. Let's take one of those. Let's see, can I get the map to scroll over? Yeah. Money man. Let's take you, Smear Merchant. You're gonna go right on down to Texas. So that's turn 13. Oh! Wow. Ohio's become somewhat of a battleground state now, hasn't it? It's an unpredicted development. Well, I guess we just have to go back to Ohio then. But not after doing some more things here. I oppose, I favor open borders. Whatever. Let's take some money and run. Sure, why not? You can go spin doctor. Go to Ohio. Me. Let's make a stop. I don't know where. Wisconsin. And then from there, we're going to go straight on to Ohio. And, let's see. Let's get a fixer. These are all our guys. Do they have any... Wow. A kook, huh? Let's deal with this dude. Hire operative. Nice. Okay, let's keep building things. Only costs $1 million to upgrade. Let's get some key endorsements. And you know, just save up some more political capital to get somebody else next turn. Yeah, fundraiser might not be a terrible thing. Although I've got plenty of funds, so... I favor election integrity. And... yeah, let's go on down here. Who knows what might await us? Nice. Lowers opponent integrity by half in target state. But do you think that's going to have any impact? You honestly think that's going to change anything? Well, let's find out. Let's put all our guys into Texas, just to see if we could take Texas. Although, honestly, I do need to go down there myself. I can't just have operatives do everything for me. I don't even have a building in Texas, do I? Let's build something. Let's build an outreach center. For all the poor, underserved people of Texas. Let's see. Yeah. Let's get a consultant. And let's get an intimidator. You know, why not? Oh yeah, we got like our entire task force in Texas. Oh no, I missed out on the later show. Bummer. We'll never get to see that now. Alright, let's do a fundraiser in Texas, because they got money. I keep accidentally double-clicking. Sadly, I've not. I don't know. I've not seen the one and the only. So whatever I speak on is going to alienate some people. That's a pity. Sure. That seems like a thing. Let's go back to Ohio. But not before making a stop in Indiana. Alright. Do we need all these people here, truly? Actually, we do need that one. This guy, on the other hand, could possibly be better served up here. Yeah, I know, I hear. On the other hand, you have to think that You must be doing well. Sure, why not? Wow, we're not able to take North Carolina. That's really surprising. Oh no, they've got the Tea Party movement supporting them. Let's take this one. Gotta get those endorsements. Yeah, I guess we have to give a speech. Something about elections and integrity and wealth gaps and stuff. People, once again, remember who we are. Let's see. I still don't have any ads, so I don't need an ad guru, but let's take an intimidator. And make a trip down here. I suppose we can build a thing. Let's build another outreach center. Sure. Why not? Wow. Alright, so lots going on the map at the moment. We're on week 19 of 21. But yeah, maybe... I mean, we're on the verge of getting this state, apparently. We'll send a running mate down there. Try to deal with that situation. As we go down here, give a last minute speech to try to get people to realize that Zika is kind of a big deal in Florida, in case they haven't figured it out yet. And yeah, I guess make a couple stops. I guess here. I guess Texas, though. Yeah, we'll make a stop in Texas. Make a stop in North Carolina. And make a stop over here. Oh, nice. And the eve of the election, we actually have some cash to operate with. So, does my opponent have any operatives I want to do anything about? Does my opponent have any... Oh, what are you doing here? Let's move you somewhere useful. If we can move you. I don't know if we can, but... Gosh darn it, we're gonna try. Okay. But yeah, does my opponent have any operatives anywhere on the map? Apparently not. Apparently they're kind of a... lone wolf. So, having a fixer is not going to do any good for me at the moment. Yeah, let's get another intimidator. Alright, where am I? Where did I just go? I'm up here. Okay. Let's see, there's 15 votes at stake, 18 votes at stake, 11, 10, 10, 3, 3, 5, 6, 3, 4, 15. Alright, we're going there, guys. And we're going to give a speech here about how bathrooms are cool. Let's do a fundraiser. Oh yeah, look at us bringing in the dough. Let's win this endorsement. And I don't know. It's a bit late in the game, but sure. Let's get an operative here. All right. Week 21 of 21. This is for all the marbles, guys. Oh, it looks like I've got a lock on Texas. That's cool. You don't expect that. Raises awareness by 3% in state and 1.5% in adjacent states. So, yeah. Mr. Clinton, would you go here, please? Let's see, can we move some of our other resources? Let's see. Yeah, this guy would be perfect here. Let's see, his issue rating's a big deal here. I can't really tell. Let's just move everybody into North Carolina. Give one big ol' speech about the wealth gap. And sure, we'll hire, I don't know, another consultant? Another intimidator? Yeah. Oh, not enough for that. We've got 11. 11 isn't really enough to get anything that helps us. Because our opponent doesn't have any operatives that I can target, and I'm not running any ads. Well, I guess we're going to run an ad, which is silly, but sure, why not? Let's create an ad, I guess. Let people know that I oppose the bathroom bill. And put this on TV in North Carolina. So our North Carolinians know exactly where we stand on bathrooms. Okay. Here we go. So, we're leading 58, 62 to nothing. 65, 78. Aww. So much for the idea of a perfect victory. We did get New York, which is pretty cool. Got Florida. So we've basically won the election already. We haven't even crossed, like, into mountain time. $270 to win. Yep, so we won this before even going into mountain time. Take that, mountains. Dang those mountains. Yeah, very nice. So, so we got a Democratic victory. Clinton's won the day in the presidency with a strong showing in both the popular vote and the Electoral College. One of the deciding factors in Clinton's victory was her use of political capital, which, you know, Trump had tons of political capital, but just couldn't use it. Clinton spent way more money than Trump. Yeah, but we're playing in easy mode, so of course we have access to that money. So. I mean, yeah. This is the Political Machine 2016. I like this. I was not expecting this to be nearly as good as it was. Just, they've really streamlined things from the previous game. In the previous game, you would click on things and it just wouldn't be responsive at all. It was quite a hassle to deal with, and they really, much to my surprise, made this game a lot easier to use. And, okay, sure, I didn't get as many events because, I don't know, I just got distracted or had too many things going on here. I really liked the mini games they had in the previous game. It was seemingly easier or more common to encounter them, but really cool. Oh, we could play ranked matches, guys. Oh, man. Oh, I clicked on the rankings thing. That brought up a browser. We're not going to deal with that at the moment. Oh, okay, so we can't do campaign mode unless we get the campaign DLC. So that's the catch. Last game campaign was a built-in feature. This time it's DLC. I remember arguing about this on the forums, at least I think with the previous game, that campaign used to be a feature in the previous game. Made it into DLC. And I said, well, I don't think that's legal, but whatever. Yeah, this game is a lot better than what I thought it would be. Hope you guys enjoyed this. It's a bit of an adventure. Let's see who made this fine game. Stardock Entertainment. So yeah, hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Go out there and vote and know what you're voting for. Understand the consequences that are at stake. Things are not always what they appear to be. It's really easy to get people riled up around causes. It's much more difficult to get people to act in their own best interests. So with that said, yeah, thanks for watching, and hope to see you guys next time. The soundtrack's pretty cool. I wonder if this is the same music guy they had for last game. Seems like they had quite a team of people working on this. Licensed technology. Uses Bink Video. Uses Miles Sound System. These guys must know what they're doing. That's pretty cool. I don't know so much about that, but this game is really reactive in terms of just it plays sounds. There's like no delay when you click on things, it plays the sounds right away and it doesn't stop the game. And so it seems like they knew what they were doing technology wise there. I'm not sure what else there is to that. Yeah, this is Political Machine 2016. Yeah, I won both as both candidates. I played one round apiece. Yeah, kudos to this guy too for the computer AI. It's difficult to make a good AI. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed. If you missed that, you can always check it out, video on demand. Although, chances are, if you're hearing this, you've probably already seen this on demand, and anyway, yeah, thanks for watching. I'll answer questions in a minute, but for everybody else, have a good one. So, yeah, let me just go into the tutorial and explain what the game's about. We just finished a couple games of this. But I don't mind explaining it. This probably would have been a better thing to start this session with than to end with, but you know. I'm Professor Yubborn, PhD, and you're on the brink of my great chasm of knowledge. So, let's begin. Electoral College. For a candidate to win, their focus has to be on winning electoral votes. When the campaign's in its infancy, it's vital to look at the electoral votes view and plan out your strategy. State data tells you way too much about each state, such as who cares about what issues, how much people think about you on a particular issue, as well as how much money does the state have to give in terms of if you visit them over and over, will they help your campaign? Candidate stands on the issues, what ties them to the common folk, So apparently each candidate stands somewhere on issues. You have a home state, obviously. I'm not sure if you get a bonus there or not. On the first week of campaigning, good starting decisions to upgrade your home base. Didn't know that. You can build buildings to help support your campaign. You can give speeches to support your campaign. Assuming you're good at speeches. You want to pick topics that your base agrees with and that independents agree with. And it's really difficult to appeal to people of the other party, so you don't necessarily have to appeal to them. Your goal is just to try to get as many votes as possible. At least in battleground states. You can get an idea of how much money you can raise in funds and how much people like you and are aware that you exist. In terms of maximizing turnout, go to places. Yeah. Make sure you have an HQ and or ads in a state. I guess I didn't know about the ads thing, but make sure people know. Also, if you got a guy who knows how to reach out to wealthy people, put them in a state where there are wealthy people. And yeah, you can win endorsements from various groups. Get all kinds of positive PR, negative PR, whatever it is that you want to encourage. If you see a green question mark indicated by this gray question mark, you want to go there. If you see a yellow question mark indicated by this white question mark, you might not want to go there. If you see a red question mark indicated by this darker gray question mark, you don't want to go there. It makes a lot of sense. You got activists that do all kinds of modifiers. And yeah, interviews are pretty cool. I kind of wish you could just do just an interview-only session. Oh, you can hit previous and next to iterate through these, so you only have to click each one. Who knew? So the tutorial isn't so much of a tutorial as it is just a manual. So yeah, that's The Political Machine 2016. It's been an adventure, guys. I wonder if I could actually get an opponent here. Given this time of year, I might actually be able to get an opponent. I don't know. Do we go for it? I just am afraid that this could drag out forever. So, I think I want to avoid that. I'd much rather have the campaign offline DLC stuff. But I'm not sure that that's worth it either. Man, this music's obnoxious. After a few minutes. There we go. So yeah. That's Political Machine 2016. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you missed any of it, catch the video on demand. Either way, it's been fun, and I hope to see you guys around. As for just personal stances, I think it's just important for people to make sure that they're they're informed as well as trying to vote in a way that supports their beliefs and their interests. I don't think any one person's, I don't know, it is your civic duty to go out there and vote, and it makes a much greater difference at a state and a local level than it does at a federal level. And the notion that any one person's presidential vote is going to change an election is kind of absurd. But you can make a greater change at local and state levels. And make sure that you understand just who you're voting for, who you're supporting. Take some time, do a little bit of research on like who's going to be on your ballot. What it is that they do, what it is they believe and how you know that they believe that, as opposed to they just tell you, oh yeah, I believe X, Y, and Z. See if they've got any kind of record to back that up. Just take some time, learn a little bit about candidates. Don't just vote straight down the ticket. Unless that is, I don't know. I don't know why people would do that. Some people do. They're the same people who would watch a particular channel and have some kind of loyalty to a particular channel. Or whatever that is. But yeah, it's important that people go learn about who's on the ballots, especially at a local and state level. And just not so much, I mean, voting is important, but remember that there are 364 other days in the year. There are plenty of opportunities to make a difference at a local and state level. You don't have to just wait for the one time every year or every 4 years or whatever to vote. You can also elect to make a difference at other times during the year and not just by voting. That said, yeah, it is your civic duty to learn about who's on the ballot and make a difference in that way too. So that is an important thing. Maybe at some point I'll go back and play through, what was it, civics.org or something. There is a simulator that helps you learn about what civic duties each citizen has and how government works. Maybe that'd be worth going back to at some point. But yeah, hope you enjoyed, and hope to see you around.